Congresswoman Lauren Boebert, her restaurant closed down. Give you some background as to why. She has a restaurant called Shooter's Grill. It has officially shut down after running her restaurant for years. The congresswoman is saying it is no more. All right. Shooter's Grill officially closed on Wednesday. It officially closed on Wednesday after she could not secure another lease. In June, Boebert was told by her new landlord, Milken Enterprises, that her lease would not be renewed. That's according to the postindependent.com. Okay. There's more. She soon called to beg, but there was not really much wiggle room or anywhere to compromise unless we bought the building ourselves. She claimed that she was not being evicted. The lease is not being renewed. That's a big difference, the congresswoman said. Boebert isn't sure what's next for her career, but she wants to continue her pro shooting brand. Now, if anyone ever went to this restaurant, you would notice that there's a theme at her restaurant. All of the waitresses, they carry guns. They have guns on their side. All right. I don't know if they're loaded or not. I have no idea. But that's the thing. Okay. All right. We should just dramatically scale it back because obviously we're not in our building, she said. It may look like Shooter's coffee shop with pastries and some easy breakfast sandwiches and merchandise. Congresswoman Boebert said she started the restaurant to give jobs to female inmates at the Garfield County Jail so they could trade their shame for glory. The gun and shooting theme only came after Boebert said someone was allegedly beaten to death in front of the building. But in fact, the person actually died of a methamphetamine overdose in front of the building. Okay. So interesting stuff here, right? The spin is on. But let's go back to the fact that Boebert has basically called for the death of President Joe Biden twice that we know of. That Congresswoman Boebert is also antithetical to democracy. She does not like the formation of the Constitution. She believes that the church is supposed to be in charge of America, according to a statement she made recently. That in fact, the church itself, according to her, was supposed to always be in charge. By the way, that is completely contrary to the foundational documents of this nation and everyone who decided to run away from church rule. But this is what happens when you put someone in Congress who did not pay attention in civics class. These are basic elements of truth. And while she's spouting this ridiculous nonsense, there's a crowd in front of her of Christian evangelicals who are applauding the misinformation. All right. Well, Jackson, no more Shooter's restaurant. What is the state going to do?
Well, it's going to be a Shooter's garage restaurant now. But, you know, I think it's interesting that conservatives, it just seems that, you know, so much of what they do, especially at least, you know, the American conservative movement, is they go out of their way to try to be offensive. That's really all this restaurant was about, is triggering the libs. You see the same thing with the LGBTQ community, with right-wing pundits, for instance, you know, like how Elliot Page, you're like, oh, I don't want to call a new name. Why can't I call people whatever I want to call them? It's like they gather around and they have these, you know, hollow debates as if they're such geniuses. But at the end of the day, it's like, well, if your business failed, it failed. If you gotta get up out of there, you gotta get up out of there. And, you know, welcome to capitalism. So I can't find any sympathy for Lauren Boebert for anything that's going to continue to come her way.
Yeah, there you go. All right.